Hello, I'm Shaun Dunne, a theatre artist and drama facilitator, and today I'm going to be giving you three simple exercises that you can use with your group in a beginner's drama workshop. So first things first, in any workshop I would always recommend that you start by doing a relatively simple warm-up, just something to break the ice and get everybody looking at each other. So gather in a circle if you can. People can sit or they can stand if they want to, that's absolutely fine. And I would encourage the participants and yourself to just look around the room, make eye contact with each other, give each other a little smile, a little nod, just to let us all know that we're all here. And then when that's done, after a moment, you can give your hands a rub, the backs as well. And then you can pass a clap around the room, around that whole circle. And all you're doing in this exercise is making contact, creating an energy, developing a rhythm. After a while, you can start to speed up the clap, you can slow down the clap, you can pass the clap across the circle, you can create any sort of game around this clap. But it's just about uniting the group and getting us all together, and it's a little bit of a game that just gets people connecting and not thinking too much and outside of their heads, hopefully. So I would always start, again, just to reiterate, eye contact, a little smile, that can be silent, looking at each other, acknowledging each other's presence, warming the hands up, and then passing the clap around the room, creating that rhythm. After a while, once that rhythm has been established, you can create a little bit of a game out of it. You can pass the clap across, you can speed it up, you can slow it down, you can clap at the same time to create that unity in the group. And all you're doing is breaking the ice and getting everybody on the same page for what's to come. At the core of every drama workshop tends to be improvisation. And this is the act of making things up on the spot, thinking fast, creating short stories, scenes, dialogues with your partners or with your group, just off the top of your head, live. So today, that's what we're going to start doing. The main block that people tend to experience when they are improvising for the first time is that they're in their head, they're nervous, and they struggle with coming up with things just off the cuff. So we want to make that as easy as possible in our first few exercises, just because we want everyone to get comfortable, we want them to feel good, and it's a muscle that you're developing over time, so we want to keep it simple to start. So the first exercise that we're going to do is based around the word hello, and it's really very, very simple. Hello. I say hello to you. Your job then is to say hello back to me. You pass that around the circle as much as possible. If I say hello to you, you say hello back. Then you go to somebody else, you say hello to them, they say hello back. That pattern is passed around much in the same way that you're passing the clap around in the last exercise. So what you have is a lot of people in the circle, maybe walking up to each other, or maybe just making eye contact, depending on physically what's at play in the room. And you're just saying hello. That's all. After a while, however, the facilitator, you, will decide to ask people to play with their hello. So what happens if the hello is a whisper? What happens if the hello is a shout? What's the intention behind certain hellos? How many times can the dynamic of hello be passed between the same people? And how many different meanings can we imbue into this one word? So you can kind of stretch this exercise out for a while. And really what the people in the group have to do is think with the one word, how many different ways can they use that word to create new meanings? So it's really, really simple. And again, it's just a warm up where people are coming together. They're saying the word hello. We all know that word usually. And they're developing a flow. Hello, hello, back and forth, louder, softer, a whisper, with anger, with a laugh. We're starting to build story already. So the hello exercise has hopefully gone pretty well and everybody in the group has mastered it. And now you, the facilitator, are ready to complicate things a little bit more for them. So now what you're going to do is you're going to add a line into that improvisation exchange. So it starts with a hello. There's a hello in response. And then person A, the person who said the first hello, has one other line, which is, I have to tell you something. When that person says, I have to tell you something, they go live, which means they are making things up on their own, they're thinking off the top of their head, and they are coming up with story, scenario, dialogues, conflicts, fresh. So they're improvising, basically. Now, at first, they will find this difficult, they will find it funny, they might be a little bit embarrassed, and there might be a lot of laughter, or it could be a little bit awkward, and there might be a little bit of a block happening where people can't think of things, or maybe shut each other down. That's okay. Acknowledge those tensions. Acknowledge those laughs, have a laugh with it. But you as a facilitator should start to tune into when it's working and what the blocks are and make sure that that understanding has been promoted in the group. So if the first thing goes really well or is kind of uncomfortable between the A and the B, where it's hello, hello, I have to tell you something. If it doesn't go great, you should draw everyone's eye as much as possible to why that worked or didn't work. So for example, B, you felt like you didn't really have a response for that person when they told you that they loved you. What could you have potentially said? Bring the rest of the group in, let them contribute. And if it was really stiff or if it was really clunky, give them an opportunity to go again. But eventually the group should become more warm, they should become muscled in this, that you should have lots of scenarios just popping up as we move around the group, and these hellos and these I have to tell you somethings begin to develop into other scenes. A really useful tool for you as a facilitator is, as the outside eye, you can stop the improv and you can move it on. So if I come up to you and I say hello, and you say hello, and then I say I have to tell you something, and you go, what is it? And then I go, well look, I'm your father. The scene starts to take place. It goes on for a little while. Maybe it's funny, maybe it's a little bit stiff. You as a facilitator take the opportunity to end it by clapping. When you clap, person B, which is the person that was approached, they then make their way over to somebody else in the circle and they start the same rapport, only this time, after the I have to tell you something, it's a brand new scenario. So again, people are having to constantly invent, constantly come up with new things, and they're developing that muscle in improvisation as they move around the room. Okay, so you're coming to the end of your first workshop and everybody has been working live and on their feet and inventing as they go and becoming improvisation masters, obviously. But at this point now, it might be useful to divide a group into smaller groups and allow them the opportunity to plan some of their improvisations. So they're still going to be making things up, they're still going to be inventing on their feet, but they have an opportunity now for 5 or 10 minutes to talk to each other and to plan a scenario and rehearse it a little bit before they show it to the group. Again, because they're a beginner's group, they might find this tricky, there might be a few blocks, so you as the facilitator can help them by reminding them of the three headings that they can use in planning an improv. So what is the location? Where is it set? What is the relationship? Who are these characters to each other? And what is the situation? So what is the conflict or the reason for us to be viewing them today? What's going on that is captivating the audience, that is drawing us in? So for example, I might build a really quick improvisation around a family home, 3 siblings, and some missing money. Okay, so the situation is the missing money, the relationship is the siblings, and the location is the family home. So from there then, the group would have the opportunity to plan a short improvisation, put it on its feet, show it to the group, everybody would show their planned improvs, and then very importantly, the core thing that I would always recommend is that you encourage feedback at the end of each sharing. Because from there then, you will start to have a conversation about story, you'll start to have a conversation about character, and as a group, you will begin to develop an understanding about what's necessary, because people know implicitly, inherently, what's necessary in good story and a good character and good drama scenarios. So I hope that some of these exercises are useful as just a way in, a very, very early days beginner's entry into drama workshops. And please consult the handout that I've also sent in addition to these videos. And good luck with your classes.